Today, a bit of a rant and an explanation of that sigma values tile in a pivot table that has multiple value fields. I don't know, what do you call this? This thing right here, the sigma sign with the word values. I always call it sigma values. I guess if you don't know that it's a sigma, you might call it a summary tile or that weird looking E tile, that mathy looking thing, backward Z thing, strange math letter, whatever you call it. What's it for and how does it show up? So here we have a simple little pivot table, products down the side and quantity. If I would put, let's say, region across the top, and then here, this is right here, this is what's going to do it. When I add a second values, then we get this sigma values thing, and it allows us to rearrange the pivot table. So right now we have east quantity followed by east revenue, central quantity, central revenue, west quantity, west revenue. But maybe you want all the quantities together. So that's where you take this values and drag it up above region and drop. Then we get quantity for east, central, and west. Now that's because I have a custom list with that. And then revenue for east, central, and west, and then sum of quantity and sum of revenue. The thing that's irritating to me is I always feel like sum of quantity should be here between column D and E, but it always ends up on the right-hand side. All right, now some other places we can put this, we can put it before product. So we get all the quantity first, and then the revenue with quantity and revenue at the bottom, or we can put it after product. And you can imagine, of course, that there are times where you have multiple fields here, so maybe both product and sector, and then you could put it between the two, although that looks really kind of weird, I guess, right? Okay, so that's what it's for. I think it's called sigma values. I don't know. I've always wondered, there's a video in the past where we can create a data model pivot table and then create a set based on column items, and I figured I should be able to take this item and move it from column H to column E. So let's go back and try this again. So insert, pivot table. This time I'm going to check the box for add this data to the data model. We'll put product down the side, region across the top, and quantity and revenue. A couple things to note, central, east, and west. A data model pivot table does not respect the custom list and is not picking up that new thing where we're getting the formatting from the underlying data. Right, so data model pivot tables were really, really good, but I think Microsoft has just kind of given up on supporting them at this point. So I'm going to take the sigma values and move it up above region. So that gets me quantity, central, east, and west. And then my goal is to take total sum of quantity and move it right here. Okay, so because this is a data model pivot table, we can compare fields, items, and sets. Create a set based on column items. And I'm going to take this item right here, sum of quantity, and move it up and drop it right there. So up, that's in the right spot. And let's just take the east and rearrange that. So east, move that up, and east, move that up, all right? And this is called set one by default, and I'm just gonna leave it like that. It's interesting that right now we have values and region here. When I create a set, that gets replaced by the set. So we have this new thing called a set. And you see that we now have east before central. That worked great, but I must be breaking some cardinal rule or there's a bug in Excel, I'm not sure which. Total sum of quantity, which I wanted to move from H to E, did not move. Can't figure that one out. What are we gonna do? Maybe we're gonna copy this and paste its values and then just rearrange things, as we want. It's hard to say. All right, so that's the story. Let me know down in the YouTube comments below if you like my name of Sigma Values and the weirdest name that you've heard anyone call this thing. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.